What's up, friends, and welcome back to the channel. Today I received my very first solar power generation unit, and this kit is sponsored by Jackery, one of the leading brands in portable solar generation units. This model is called the Jackery Explorer 1000 version 2, and it comes with the Jackery Solar Saga 200 solar panel. So with the rising cost of power everywhere, everyone would like to get their hands on one of these units. So without wasting any more time, I'll get right to it. And welcome back. And in this kit, you get the Explorer 1000 V2 model, a heavy duty AC power cable for charging along with its user manual. And in the Solar Saga 200 bucks, you have the foldable solar panel, its multi-purpose DC charging cable for the solar generator, and its user manual. So I'll first start with the solar generator. There are actually two models, the Explorer 1000 and the Explorer 1000 version 2. At the time of making this video, the Explorer 1000 is sold out, so it's recommended that you purchase this latest version, which has better battery performance and life cycles than version 1. So it weighs 23.8 pounds, which is 10.8 kilograms, and measures 12.8 inches wide by 8.82 inches long by 9.72 inches tall. So it's one of the smaller units, but make no mistake, it provides lots of power. This V2 model provides a remarkable 1500 watts of pure sine wave AC power via its three AC power sockets, which is 50% higher than its previous models. For DC power, you get up to 100 watts via one of its USB Type-C ports, 30 watts on another USB Type-C port, 18 watts via a single standard USB-A port, and you get up to 10 amps via the 12 volts car charging port. It comes with a lithium iron phosphate battery with 4,000 cycles to 70% plus capacity. On its right side, you have AC charging via direct AC power, and it also supports AC bypass up to 1500 watts. This allows it to power connected devices while charging at the same time. And for solar charging, it comes with two DC 8mm sockets, each of which has a max charging capacity of 200 watts. The included Solar Saga 200 outputs 200 watts. However, you can also use two 100 watts on one channel. This will require a splitter sold separately. So the sockets can accommodate up to 400 watts combined using two 200 watts panels or four 100 watts panels ranging from 12 volts to 60 volts with 8 amps all the way up to 21 amps. This unit has a built-in thermo-regulated cooling fan, so it only switches on when needed to cool the unit. The intake vent is on the right and the exhaust is on the left. You can hear the fan if you are close enough, but you cannot hear it from a distance of 1 meter. Also, it comes with a handy flashlight feature, and if you press the button twice as well as using the included app, you can set it to send out an SOS. Unfortunately, unlike some of the other models, this model does not support battery expansion. So to begin using this unit, they made the interface very simple and user-friendly. You simply press and hold the power button for 2 seconds to turn it on. You will immediately see on its display its current battery status, its input and output usage, and its Bluetooth and Wi-Fi connectivity, which works together with the included Android and iOS app, which I will get to in just a moment. To begin using it, you simply press the AC button and the green LED will turn on, and the same can be done for its DC power ports. You simply press the DC power button and the green LED turns on. To turn them off, you simply press them again. Both AC and DC can be used at the same time. So currently, its battery is at 24%, The cell phone charger is drawing 16 watts and the glue gun is drawing around 20 watts. So that's around 30 watts total. It says that it can provide power for the next 5.5 hours. However, it features AC bypass while charging. So if you connect its power cable, it powers devices while charging at the same time. It shows that with the AC power cable connected, it draws 1030 watts and it will fully charge in 1.2 hours. So that's the wattage of your average microwave. It will take much longer to charge via the solar panels. With no devices drawing power, it uses about 1000 watts for charging. And at this current rate, it will fully charge in 1.1 hours. With the Jackery app for iOS and Android, you can connect to the generator firstly via Bluetooth to monitor and control all of its features. While connected via Bluetooth, you can also connect the generator to your Wi-Fi, which will ensure that it receives the latest firmware updates. You can monitor its battery status, its input and output wattage. You can enable or disable its AC and DC switches. You can control the brightness of its display, enable the SOS light feature, and you can set the display timer from 2 minutes to 2 hours, or you can turn it off. Under the cloud icon, you can connect the generator to your Wi-Fi, and once connected, you can perform firmware updates. Currently, the weather is overcast, so I'll pause this video and wait for sunny skies to resume my testing. So it's been a couple of days before I finally got some fine weather, and here I'm outside at the park with the solar generator and the Solar Saga 200 panel. Firstly, I was surprised with the length of the solar panel. When unfolded, it measures 6.7 feet, which is 2.3 meters. So you've got to prepare yourself for that because you will need some space to spread open that solar panel. At the park, the sunshine did not last very long, so I was unable to film the solar charging. So I will demonstrate on another day when the sunshine is better. So this is day 3 and I finally have some great sunshine. You have a couple of options to charge the generator. You can use the solar panel, which outputs 200 watts. On a depleted battery or below 10% power, this can take up to 7.5 hours to fully charge, or shorter if the battery already has some charge. You can also use the generator to power devices and charge via solar at the same time, provided that the device is not drawing over 200 watts. Alternatively, you can power small 5V devices directly off of the solar panel with the included multi-purpose charging cable. It comes with an LED light to indicate that it's getting power, and you have a USB Type-C port and a USB A port. The next option is to use car charging via your cigarette lighter connected to one of its DC charging ports. This will require a special cable sold separately. I placed a link to that cable in the description below, and honestly, I think that they should have included this cable in your purchase. Your third option is to use a power inverter connected to your car battery. Here is connected to my 1500 watts inverter, consuming approximately 670 watts for charging. This will increase to 1000 or more while using devices at the same time. So the generator uses AI to determine how much power is needed while charging to effectively charge the battery and power devices at the same time. So for real world usage, here, an electric kettle is consuming approximately 1400 watts of power, which is just below its max output, and at this rate it will only last 45 minutes. However, you need not worry, because it does not take that long to boil a kettle of water. Here, I'm using a leaf blower and it's drawing approximately 1200 watts, which will give you just about over 1 hour to blow the leaves out of your yard or your driveway. So back indoors, I connected it to my gaming PC and my entire system is drawing 284 watts from a full charge, which gives me approximately 3.7 hours of backup power. I would also like to mention that while charging via AC cable, the AI recalibrates the amount of power needed to charge the battery the closer it comes to a full charge. This way, it does not constantly draw 1000 watts from your wall socket during the charging process to conserve energy. And when the battery reaches 100%, it switches off the AC charging until it drops below 99%. In summary, the Explorer 1000 I would recommend for most household appliances and electric tools. Its portable design allows you to take it camping and on events such as backyard parties and watching movies using your projector outdoors. With its 200 watts solar panel, you are equipped with various options to charge your mobile devices and other equipment. And by using modern technology such as a mobile app and AI charging, it ensures that you conserve power and monitor and control your usage at the same time without having to be close to the generator. These generators are very popular these days, and it's an invaluable tool to have at your disposal. The generator and solar panel are well built using the strongest materials, offering great value for your money. So as your portable option, the Explorer 1000 version 2 is ideal, and at the time of making this video, you can get the kit for $7.49 on Amazon or directly from their website at $7.99. See the links in the description if you would like to check them out. I also placed a link to the car charging cable if you are interested in that accessory. So that sums up this review. Special thanks to Jackery for sending their latest product for review. If you like this product and found this video useful, then give it the thumbs up. I would really appreciate your support. If you are new to the channel and would like to join my community, then click the subscribe button and ring the notifications bell. This way, you'll receive notifications when I release new videos or for one of my products at secondhand prices or decide to do a giveaway. Thanks for taking the time to watch this video. Stay connected and see you in the next one.